And hello everyone. Welcome to Twitch and Tuesdays with Seymourgoo, and that's me. Hope everyone's doing well this evening. Morning, afternoon, whatever it might be. Where you are. They did get around to doing that. Was just checking my buffs down here. Making sure we had them up a bit. I know for a while there, people weren't keeping up with them, so just check. Not sure what I'm doing today. Might be switching characters, might be switching servers. Not sure, but I figured I'd start off with Shaw. Try to finish off this level. Get to 24. Which would be nice. Oh, and look at all the LFMs. We looks like we have some choices. Let us see what seems interesting here. Well, bad news, we have two ghost LFMs, looks like. And there's really nothing else that I want to do with people. So let's do some old solo route stuff. I know I did Vaughn 1 through 4 and EE yesterday. So let's do some House D stuff. Let's go ahead and start with House D, and then we'll see what we're going to go from there. Level 23. This is my 12th epic life. So I will have epic completionist after this life. And so yeah, why not try to grind this life last epic life out and get that. And then from there, I don't know what I'm going to do with this character, but at least I'll have that accomplished. I usually don't kill these guys, but I feel like killing them today. Played a little bit on Kyber yesterday. My morning lock got some. Did the U27 stuff. Got some XPs there. Played with minions also yesterday for a bit on Wayfinder. I was way under level, but didn't really have too much of a problem. I thought it'd be a little bit worse than it was. Had to drop out there because I wasn't flagged for Dreaming Dark. And what else did I do recently? Well, Friday's stream from my channel, we had Skunk, Queen, and Dag all playing on Caneth. Did some EEs, did some challenges, finished shroud flagging. Quite a little mix of stuff there we did on Friday. Can see that on my channel or on my YouTube channel, or Twitch channel, or YouTube channel, I should say. To be clear. Yeah, having a good time. I have family coming in this week and over the weekend. It's a long weekend in the US. So I will not be streaming Friday from Caneth as I have been for the past couple weeks due to that. Let me get that out of the way so everybody knows. But there are plenty of other people streaming on Friday usually, so you should still be able to watch some DDO. Gemini usually streams, Cordovan streams on here, and usually there's maybe one or two others, depending on who feels like streaming at the time. I think I might. Well, I need to get my last bit of favor, and then I might go for the TR, hero TR in here. I'm getting kind of tired of this same build. I would like something more interesting to play, something different. I mean, I've been playing this build for several years, and now that I've got some past lives and stuff, it might be time to change it up. Something somewhat similar, but a little bit different. So I could see going Barbarian or Pure Fighter or maybe Swashbuckler. Do one of the Warlock melee builds. And there's a couple options. I do want to sort of stick with the whole two-handed fighting Great Axe thing, because I do have a couple of those lying around on this particular character, so it'd be a shame to let him go to waste. I will most likely turn my post-processing off here in a minute or two. Try to take care of some of these zombies. I'd like to play something also with better saves, better self-healing. I know my monk is now in epics, and I don't have decent epic gear yet, so kind of slowed down on being the machine. It was in basically pure joy to play, but my Morning Lock is still a blast to play. Has not slowed down really into epics. The one I have epified anyway. It's still just a joy to play that character. It's fun ex also to play with the group we've got on Caneth recently. So, there's that. Let me go ahead and turn my post-processing off before I forget and get horrible video lag right here. Didn't quite get a chance to listen to the new DDO podcast, DDO Cast, newest one with about the debates. I do want to listen to that probably after tonight's stream. I'll get to it. Apparently, there's some interesting things in that particular episode. Looking forward to listening. And everybody saw that the DDO Chronicle for the week is out. And Bonnie Boo has a song featured in it, which is interesting. About permadeath. Let's see, I finally got around to watching Lessa's game of the challenge tutorial videos. I picked moving targets, I think. And wow, the auto closed captioning from the YouTubes is hilarious, especially about on the 21-minute mark. Yeah, that was funny. It's like Google Translate, but for the same language. Interesting to hear, character names and DDO terms trying to be translated, auto-translated, and it's just, yeah, it doesn't turn out well sometimes. I did put a link up to. Oh, you know what? I forgot to put my chat over here so I can actually see who that is. Just said something in the chat. Let me do that real quick. Hello, Vornami. How's it going? Hope you're doing well this evening. Glad to have you watching this here. There we go. That's better. Now I can see and read chat easier. As I was going to say, I did spend some time in my guild's airship the other day, and I put that link up in chat. You should be able to see it in the chat overlay. I also submitted that picture to the wiki. There was no. Nice. Less than a week and almost already back up there. It's pretty good. Nice quick pace for your TRs. So there's no photo about the layout of the staterooms and hold rooms and airship and stuff. So I did a screenshot, labeled all the stuff, and then made an actual chart where I show what is in each slot on the airship. It came about because I've been playing in other servers where their airships are not what I consider optimal in the way they're laid out. And I was forgetting what went where and all that stuff. So the idea was, one, to have it for my guild, and then two, put some code behind it so that if you want to see what. If you want to save your guild's airship layout and make it easy to do that. That second part, the actual saving your guild ship's air layout, hasn't come about yet. I'm still thinking about what I want to use to complete that. But the idea is that you'll be able to bookmark a link to your guild's airship and then see it as long as it's a Kraken. I haven't done any of the other ones yet. Hello, Gemini. Dentist go well? Or is it yet to come? I And Viola, next quest. That's not good. Hello, Attack 360. How's it going? Welcome, greetings. Hope you're doing well this evening. Yeah, I haven't been to the dentist in, I don't remember how long it's been. Let's just say 10 plus years. Call it good. Fun stuff. I just realized not wearing part of the gear setup I should be wearing. Why is that? Oh, might as well turn post-processing back on. So I can actually see the water and in the water. Makes a big difference. Yeah, it's just a flat plane of crap you can't see through, basically. And water is really one of the things this game does really well. I really like the water effects in this game. A shame that some other stuff means you have to turn it off from time to time to get that ugly water. Like, Shadowfell and Blacklock, basically, the two things. What was that? There's a waterfall somewhere yesterday, Gemini, you were in Thunderhome, maybe, that slowed you down. Yeah, that's a cool feature too. You can actually see stealth. Somewhat realistically. The build I'm using is that. It is an 18 fighter 2 monk. Kensai centered. At least for now. At 27, I go uncentered, but until then, I stay centered. Hey, City, how's it going? Welcome, hope you're doing well this evening. I guess I will go for the extra breakables just so I get my 10% bonus. I am not doing too bad. Got a little bit of stress with the family coming in for a visit this week, so we've been doing a lot of cleaning and rearranging and organizing. And the house keeps looking better and better. It'd be nice if we kept it up this way, but that just doesn't seem to happen for some reason. So every time people come visit, it's a rush to, oh my God, we gotta clean everything. Yeah, the problem is that I change them every time I reincarnate, so it's not like they're static. I play around with them. The Epic Ethereal Bracers are really not hard to get. They are nice, though. Of course, I can't wear them most of the time, so there's that problem. But yeah, this character is 12th epic life right now, so after I complete this life, epic life, I'll have epic completionist. And then I might do the whole finally get around to getting those last couple quests I need for the 5K favor, and after that, I might actually heroic reincarnate. Yeah, all that orchard gear is, as long as you're not talking about the raid gear, but the just or drops in the orchard gear. There's usually, at least on Thalanus, I've noticed there's lots of LFMs up. If you don't get it in each of the quests, then your end reward for the chain can drop them, and you've got several chances to get them. They're not too difficult. I think I have three sets of them, I think. I don't remember off the top of my head how many I have. But I know more than just this character has them. Because they are that handy. I'm wearing the Sun Soul set at the moment because I am not that level yet where I can use those. I never really planned on getting that set, it's just that I ran those quests and just happened to get them. So I use them, but I spend very little time. I spend time at 27 to get 28, and then 28 I have a great reincarnate again. So that set doesn't see much use. Yeah. I would like to get some boots of propulsion, but that's really hard to find groups for. And it's just such an awkward area to do anything in. I would love for this character to have boots of repulsion. That would be fun. I might do pretty well without. What do I have on for my boots anyway? I have fortification hit points on my boots. I didn't realize that. Maybe I should head out there and try for those Oh, the banding's really fun today. There we go. Only two tries, not too bad. I still haven't done one of those raids, and that's one of the things I need for favor. I occasionally see LFM set for it, but usually they're in progress, and they've been in progress for a while, so fighting my way back through the whole explore area to get there and doing the raid, just eh. Keep passing on it. Oh, I miss having that permanent shield that my warlock has. Really harried by animated armors. Come on, that's garbage. Yeah, I've got a clicker in here somewhere, but just nice not to have to worry about it. Just permanent shield all the time. See, we're at 8%, and now we're at 10%. Vandal bonus. Love it. There's most of the XP I needed to get to level. Let's see what else can be run. And go over to House P. Ah, yes, tech support. I love it when I get a call. My computer, or printer, or scanner, or something isn't working. Okay, I'm over 1,000 miles away. What do you want me to do about it? Trying to debug that stuff over the phone is not fun. When the person doesn't really know what they're talking about. They're trying, but they just don't know what they're talking about. A quick party crashers and a quick snitch, see how, where that leaves us XP wise. Actually, I should check LFMs real quick. Still nothing decent. Okay. I have done not Skype, but go to my PC or log me in or one of those things before. And that has helped, but when the problem is the actual internet connection, yeah, it doesn't help at all. I suppose if I wanted to, I could do a video call from phone to phone and try it that way, but meh. It's much easier to say, yeah, have one of the other relatives that actually lives close to you come out and see what they can do for you. Oh my God, dog. Oh. Whew. What did you eat? Yeah, the last problem ended up being something with their provider. I don't remember what they said it was. But something to do with their line being something or other. They had to replace part of the line or something. Like, yeah, I couldn't have helped you with that anyway. Yeah. Amazing how often that works. I'll just reboot it. That can work. Exactly, Gemini. Exactly. Sadly, one of my laptops is like that. It did it earlier to me today, in fact. It just suddenly started sprouting static out of the speakers for no apparent reason. And it persists until you turn it off. And then once you turn it back on, it's fine. Nothing wrong with it. And I originally sent it back while it was still under warranty to have it fixed, and they replaced the motherboard, and it still does it. Not as frequently, but it still does it. And I had another laptop that if you turn it off, you may not be able to turn it back on again. It may not boot. That's why I will not buy Dell or Alienware any longer. Which is sad because they came out with new 13-inch laptops that I would normally be all over, but nope. I've got it to boot, I think, once in the last 20 tries, and just booted up fine. No problems. And then, okay, it worked. Great. So it's fixed, right? Turn it back off and it won't turn on again. Like, all right. Never mind. Something really wrong with it. So I think I'm going to go MSI like next time I get a new laptop. Because these Asus ones are pretty good, but they have weird issues. I used to like Dell, but they kind of went to crap. Support policies and knowledge of blah. No, it actually will come up and tell you that there's no video card or video card error or something, and then it won't boot anymore for next tries. And then after, 20 or so tries, it'll say, "Hey, everything's working fine, no issues whatsoever." And when I called in, they wanted me to go through this whole routine of, "Did you turn it on, turn off, turn it back on again?" Yeah. "Did you try doing this?" Yeah. "Did you try doing this?" Yeah. Look. The error says the video, it's a video card problem. Can we progress to that step? Well, no. Okay. What's the point? I've tried everything you're telling me to try. It's not working. Why won't you send me a coffin so I can send it in? You guys can fix it. I played. I and the SO play DDO on two laptops all the time. In fact, I'm streaming from a laptop right now. So, I know people say, "Oh, laptops and Wi-Fi, you shouldn't be streaming or have problems playing." Not at all. It is an Asus gaming laptop, but yeah, no problems. No problems being on Wi-Fi, no problems streaming, no problems playing DDO. Works great. The other laptop is starting to age. I think the video card's trying to go as well, besides whatever the problem is with the static and the speakers and the sound and blah. Yeah, exactly. You practically play DD on a pebble. Not really. Don't try it at home. But yeah, it really isn't that demanding. You have to ratchet things down a bit, but you can still play. Well, it plays smooth for me nearly all the time. Of course, there's occasional, lag somewhere in the network stream or something, but as far as graphics go, it's fine. I think I've gotten pretty well up there too. What do I have everything on? High, medium. Oh, I turned some of the lighting stuff down to try to get around the whole overbright bloom stuff. But everything else is pretty high. Not really having much in the way of tearing or any artifacts. The only thing I have is those couple sections in the game where nothing goes right. Like, Black Lock, where there's just such a complex scene that it slows anything down. Or, being able to see anything in Shadowfell. It's another time to turn things down. Specifically post-processing. Fixes a lot of stuff. Yeah, most of the time, everything's great. Yeah, I took some of the lighting stuff down. And shadows a little bit down. Oops. But yeah. Using DirectX 9, 1020 by 1080. And yeah. I know people are down about the graphics sometimes. I don't really understand why. They're fine for me. I like the graphics in the game. Where did I thought I talked to Cyan. Back. Got distracted by graphics settings and just go through the right dialogues. There we go. Yeah, I've heard that DirectX 11 has problems. That's another reason I made sure to come down to 9. It's quote unquote supported, but yeah. No, you are not mistaken. The only thing you can scale is basically text size. And of course, the chat window, map window, things like that. You can't, the actual hotbars, you can't scale. You can rotate them, but you can't scale up or down. Yeah, there's a bunch of UI stuff that I would love to see fixes for. But that's not really sexy stuff that sells people on playing. It's more just quality of life improvements. The character sheet needs an overhaul and a lot more information. There's a bunch of stuff that can be done differently. Yeah, basically my feats are the Kensai weapon focus stuff, and then whatever. Yes, that is also true. The skins are still working mostly, but they aren't really technically supported anymore. I use Blackbird personally, and it works. You can see it works pretty well. Occasionally, there's issues with you can't tell which of a couple different things are equipped or things like that, but for the most part, it works fine. Yep. Yeah, I'm hoping to build a new desktop. I haven't had a desktop in, I don't remember how many years now. But I want to build a desktop, hopefully in the near future, and see what DDO is like on triple monitors. Get a nice beefy setup and see. I don't know if I want to go for those ultra wide ones or just three relatively normal ones. I don't know. Haven't decided what I want to do yet, but I'll put a system together here at some point. I'm getting tired of the limited storage space. Both laptops I have right now that I actually use have a SSD and then a 1 terabyte drive, hard drive for storage. And that's just tiny anymore. I got, like, I still have all my videos from the past, I don't know how many months, sitting on the hard drive. And yeah, I'm about to run out of space. I'm gonna need to archive some of those or delete them or something. I got a bunch of external drives, but it's just a pain to find the right external drive, plug it in, and all that. I built quite a few desktops. Actually built and sold a couple of them. Or built them for people, I guess you could say. They paid me to build systems for them. My problem every time I look at a system, though, is that I end up going my old habit of choosing top-end gear for every component. And then the total price is like, oh my God. Yeah, I don't have a job at the moment, so I can't really build anything until I get a job. Well, I could, but that would be kind of irresponsible of me. And I was moving around a lot and It made a lot of sense for me to have laptops rather than desktops at the time I switched, so. I still recommend laptops for a lot of reasons. Especially for like, parents and relatives. It's so much easier to say, "Oh, hey, bring your laptop over and I'll help you figure out what's wrong." Or grab the laptop out of its desk and work on it, then, okay, how do you have this hooked up? Why are all these cables going through all these weird places in this desk and around this thing? And it's, why is that under the chair? Oh, all that stuff. It's just, hey, here's all in one compact unit. It's easy to port and tote around and troubleshoot a lot. So. Yeah. That too. I tend to use mine for quite a while and then I just want them gone by that point. By the time they get buggy and unresponsive and aged, I'm ready to just let them go. I don't want to inflict them on anybody. Excuse me, that I know and have to support. I'd rather they just go away. I got rid of two or three laptops when I moved last. I think I sold one of them off, and then the other two I couldn't get a deal on, so I just gave them to somebody and said, "Here, you want them, deal with them. I don't want to deal with these anymore. I am done. I've got so much other crap that I'm moving, I don't want to move these as well." And my last two desktops, I just there was a community recycling day that they took electronics. All right, here, just handed them over, and the people were really impressed with my cases and lighting and all that stuff. I was like, "Oh, that's really cool. Do that yourself?" Yep. Getting rid of it? Yep. I am done with those machines. Do not want to see them again. Yes, I agree with that, Gemini. That's the reason why I liked building my own, being able to upgrade one part at a time, and if something starts going out, you can swap it. But what I found is that I bought high enough end parts that that wasn't a problem. And by the time I would upgrade, then I'd have to replace the whole thing anyway. So it's the same thing as getting a laptop. And laptop is much easier to deal with and store and move and all that. Plus, I could take it with me. So, yeah. It ended up being laptops were a better thing for me at that time. But now I have this house. I hope to stay here a while. And I have an office and all that stuff. It makes more sense to go back to desktop, being that I feel like I'm more stable now. And I miss my multi-monitors. I really do. I used to have an old, God, what were they called? Dual head. The Matrox dual head video card. I used to have one of those. And I ran, two boat anchor CRT monitors off of it. And yeah, really enjoyed that. In my office, I have two monitors, and occasionally I'll take one of the laptops up there and plug it in. And it's glorious to be able to be on those nice, two nice big screens. And I have my IKEA hack standing desk, and it's just nice. So, don't know. He was impressed with it. Did you see the guy who built that overhead control panel for his thing? I pasted that link to him the other day and he was impressed by it. He has like six monitors. I would like to build a nine monitor grid. That'd be fun. I'm planning on three. I think three will be enough for most of what I do. Although it can be argued if you're playing on three screens, then you want another screen for stuff that's non-playing. So you could do four, and if once you go down that slope, you might as well get the two other ones to make it six. So you have plenty of desktop space. You can argue that, but I don't know. I used to run two machines off of two monitors and all that stuff. I could see it, that particular style being more like if you're playing, say, EVE Online, where you could have a bunch of stuff set up for the game you're playing. I could see that more for that. But yeah, I was more worried about the weight because it looked like he had some heavy duty mounts and chains to keep that thing up so it didn't fall. He said it was pretty heavy. Where is that? Yes, it's this one. Let me think, that's the one we're talking about. Yeah, it's a pretty neat thing, but I would not survive that build, I know, personally. I'd have to have the SO do it, because they worked on arcade machines and stuff, so they have the skills. Let's see, where did I want to go next? I still need a bit of XP. Are there any good LFMs up? If you want to see something interesting, also look at some of the higher viewer count streamers on Twitch, and usually they have a like a build video either on Twitch or on YouTube. Like Professor Broman, I know, is one who did recently because he just moved and did a video of his new setup. It's interesting to see what they have and what they deem as important and the perfect setup and all that. It's generally 3 to 5 monitors and some very complicated wiring for audio and video switching. So if this is actually starting. Lords of Dust, then we'll do this. Yep. If this isn't starting right away, I will go ahead and see if I can find a link.
What's up, guys? It
Whoa. That's four, I think, but that's one of the ones I'm talking about. I don't remember who the other guy was that I watched, but he did a lot of classic gaming, so he had a he had a different monitor that was very low latency for that. Yep, it was. That was Broman. He has four. Which I should point out, Broman's a very entertaining person to watch stream. He's doing mostly Destiny now, sadly, but I don't really care for Destiny. Watching Destiny, I haven't played it, but watching it isn't great for me. But he is very entertaining. Check out his archives and his story times, and there's some fun stuff that he does. And occasionally he goes back and does Borderlands and Broforce and other stuff, but Broforce. Yeah, Broforce. Either in that video or the other one, he has two or three recent setup videos because I say he moved and he has been changing his setup a little bit. He actually does say, okay, this monitor is for this, this monitor is for this, this monitor is for this, and this monitor is for that. So chat's here, I'm playing the game here, I've got the OBS preview over here, and I can't remember what the other one was, like a web page or reference or something you can have up there. The one guy had a TV mounted on the wall that he said he was going to play other stuff through while he was doing other things on over here. I don't know. Yeah, I like the idea of a monitor dedicated to chat so you can always see the full chat. That would be nice. And then, of course, if you have partner, then you have subs and donations and all that stuff you probably want to monitor. So, say one monitor for that stuff, and then one monitor for your game, and then, reference stuff. Like, I've got how many tabs open right now? I mean, I would like to be monitoring OBS to make sure everything's working, looking right, but that's hidden behind the game. And I've got, my Dragon Cam up there and my keyboard overlay. I could make use of them. I could find a way to spread everything out intelligently, I think. But right now, I'm just watching two laptops. I've got a video preview on the other laptop. I've got Chatty running on the other laptop. And those are the two things I have up there that I can just glance over and make sure things look right. And chat's going. And then on this laptop, I've got Flow as an IRC overlay so I can see chat. So I can just read it. And then the game. And that's all I can see. All the other stuff is hidden. So, yeah. Oh, while I'm sitting here, let's go ahead and do options and mute game chat or voice chat. There we go. Three people all wearing the same armor. That's nice. So I'm waiting for this E Lords of Dust to start. So feel free to keep chatting. I'm having fun engaging. But yeah, three and then maybe fourth overhead. I like the overhead. That overhead monitor is a neat idea too. The other guy, he was using a DSLR as his main video camera on him. But then he had another webcam. I wasn't sure what that was for. I didn't normally watch the guy. I was just poking around YouTube and I fell down that YouTube hole where you find video to video to video. And that setup video I found was interesting. I guess I could look in my YouTube history and find it while we're waiting. If I can find my YouTube tab out of all this stuff. Maybe that was it. I double-clicked it accidentally. That's the other thing that's annoying is I'm see. I've got flow up in the top left corner, so anything that overlaps that, I have to kind of move out of the way or move flow. History. Let's see if I can find this. Oh, while I'm here, let's go ahead and link to Bonnie Bew's Permadeath Love Song video. If you haven't seen that, I didn't want to do that, you stupid thing. Looks like I was watching Pelike a lot, so yeah. There it is. I found it. This is the other guy I was talking about. Oh my
Focus,
gosh.
focus, focus.
Stop. You look anywhere in this stupid thing and, ugh. I don't even remember what was in that bundle. Ghost on a Bridge was terrible. Yes, I agree. I don't remember what Last Word was. And this is the one I was going to also. If you haven't seen it, LSD37 is doing a application to track gear for your character, which is pretty cool. Hey, Skunk, how's it doing? Doing well this evening. Good, good. A little bit on Kyber last night. Just for the fun of it. Didn't see anything going on Kayneth, but I found a LFM, so. All right, Gemini. Thanks for stopping by. See you later. And folks, if you're not following Gemini already, you probably should be. He streams DDO most days. He's probably the most consistent DDO streamer of late. He also will be streaming on this channel tomorrow. Thank you, Skunk, for the link. And as always, you can watch replays and stuff, Twitch and YouTube. Cordovan's pretty good about getting the shows up in highlights pretty quickly, within a day or so, most times. You can always check past broadcasts until that happens. And I always upload my stuff on YouTube as well. So there's always that option. If only, skunk. This is, the Lord's has changed something I know. I run and off enough to understand how it works, but not enough enough that I consider it one of the must-do dailies. Like, I do it every day kind of stuff. Or most days, when I'm leveling. Whew. Hello, I got aggro. I did indeed get aggro. Hello, Agro. How are you doing? I've got a little bit of lag between when I hit my abilities and when they happen, so yeah. Well, if somebody wants to do more damage to him and take the aggro off me, that'd be cool. I can't imagine I'm doing the most damage here. Come on. See you, Gemini. This being E, I do have to slightly concentrate so as not to die sometimes. I must say, I'm not that great at aggro management on this particular character. Oops. That can happen. Yeah. Always have issues with KVMs, multiple machines in the same monitor. I inevitably, or multiple keyboards and monitors together. I inevitably pick the wrong keyboard mouse or switch the KVM to the wrong one when I'm trying to do something. I end up doing something completely random on the other machine. DDO canceled. What the heck? I see. Groups night's been canceled. Was gonna say I got through there without being hit. Wow. Then of course I got hit. That's how it happens. Is this the this is the jerks down there. I'm not here. I'll wait. Unfortunately, I have to miss my group stuff this coming week because of the relatives coming into town. I have a all warlock group on Thursdays and then a guild static group on Sundays. And then a semi-static group at the moment on Caneth on Fridays, where we're trying to level for the upcoming Zerg show stuff. Warlock is in Warlock. DDO added Warlocks with the recent update. As in Eldritch Blasting from their hands, Warlocks. They are a bunch of fun to play. I actually play. That's the build that I basically play. Yep, we've been playing there on Fridays with Queen and Dag and Skunk and Tippin and Crazy Trickster. Whoever else stops by. That'd be interesting. Then go play Running with the Devils in your all-pale master group. That'd be fun. Get all that wonderful light damage. Hello, Helena of Khyber. How is it going? Hope we're doing well this evening. That's cool, Skunk. Yeah, it sounds like it'd be fun to play. I can't tell you how much fun it is to play my Morning Lock. It's just so much fun. They play kind of like monks, but ranged. It's just neat the way they work. I like them. I also have a half-orc melee aura warlock that I play. I have a Pale Trapper that I have never really played. Oh, what was that? Oh, it was the Shirley line from Airplane that dude didn't get yesterday. Or day before, whatever day that was. That was funny. Wow. Champion Geralith hits pretty dang hard. Wow, why did I get 500 damage? I thought he was frozen and unable to move. Yep. One of those things you think everybody knows and then no. Everybody looks at you blankly. I'm like, "What? I thought everyone knew that. Sorry." Hey, Skylar Wolf. Greetings, welcome. Hope you're doing well this evening. Live viewing of DDO stream of DDO. Twitchy Tuesdays. Wonder when that would come in. That's cool, Skunk. Getting some decent damage here and there on him. Do 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 do. Let's kill this dude who's really annoying. One hireling down. Oh, group leader down. Come on. Well, that helps a little bit, but it's not gonna be enough for me. I am playing Hate Magnet today, evidently. Wow. This dude's doing some serious damage. I'm trying not to go cheese him, you know? I can go on the staircase pillar and cheese him, but. Trying to give us a chance to do this legit before doing that. It's amusing that his pathing can't figure out it, that I drop down. He can't figure out what to do when I drop down. Nice, skunk. Did I actually not die that quest? Which I died once. I believe I did not die, which is good. That's a good goal for E. Not dying. But it takes some damage to my gear. Shield, shield, shield. That's enough to go ahead and do that. I am so close to level under 2K. Actually, under 1500. Well, three of us are sitting here at servants, and the party leader is sitting at the top of the stairs still doing nothing, so. Four of us at the entrance. Oh, there's the party leader finally. Phantom group. So there's only one LFM up at the moment. I've run with Galvis before. And they're doing E Beyond the Rift, which. So after this quest that will give me my level, I may switch to another character, another level, another server, I don't know. If anybody has any ideas, let me know. I'm pretty open. The only thing I really wanted to get done was get at least one level for this particular character. Yeah. Some good ones and some short-term ones that. I question how good they actually are, but. Oh, Soundburst Stun. Love it. Hate it. Your suggestion, Skunk, is noted and taken under advisement. There's a nice way of saying no, not happening. I guess, yep, somebody's. Oh, that was all I needed for the level. The first optional. That was all I needed for the level. That's ridiculous. So really the rest of this is just gravy. Unfortunately, I can't equip my better Thunderforge because I don't actually have that level yet. Not like I'm going to be super useful on these guys, but still. Basic philosophy in EE is to let somebody who can handle the tanking or and or has a plan wade in and take most of the damage. Let them engage first, and then I'll come back behind them and help DPS stuff down. Like that, I would have suggested kiting a couple at a time, not going directly for all of them right up front. I can't even tell what's going on. Is somebody going to heal me? Thank you. I'm going to stick to this cleric. That's a good idea. They'll keep me alive. Well, maybe. Just when you think that, they go and not heal me for a little bit. Well, that's because I'm not playing a warlock. That's my strategy is Shaw, because Shaw can do lots of up close damage if Shaw is not the target of all the hate. Shaw does not have enough PRR, MRR, or saves to wade in on Epic Elite most of the time. Welcome back, city. Expecting another phone call, more tech support. I think regardless, I do not want to do spinner tonight. I do not feel like doing that. I'm going to drop this group after this quest and go level real quick, and then I think I'm going to switch characters. I don't know about switching servers, but I'm at least going to switch characters. That's kind of why I'm thinking of actually finally TRing Shaw. Just want something a little bit different. But I'm having so much fun playing my morning lock that I didn't mean to do that. But yet here I am, taking all the aggro from the Hezreau. Awesome. What's with you and the oatmeal raisin, skunk? Actually, I might go have some more of those brownie batter Oreos, which I don't can't say that I like, but I can't stop eating. I've had some good oatmeal raisin, but most of the time you get those oatmeal raisins cookies that are just awful. Ugh. No, it's tomatoes, cheese, and garlic. The chocolate is a meh. It's not a bleh. See, there's a big difference. Tomatoes are a bleh. Cheese is a usually a bleh if it's melted or with something, and garlic is always a bleh. Chocolate's just meh. Now, see, yeah. Fresh mom cookies that are oatmeal raisin, even though mom never made oatmeal raisin. But yeah, that's a different thing. But most of the time, oatmeal raisins are just those cheap grocery store ones that are just blah. Ugh. I never have enjoyed tomatoes. Never have I ever enjoyed tomatoes or ketchup. I don't like lasagna, I don't like pizza, I don't like most Italian cooking. I agree with you with peas as well. Actually, I liked peas when I was younger, and now I just can't stand them. Even if they're like decent, fresh, just regular green peas, I like snap peas and snow peas, but regular just green peas. Oh, every time I have them, I'm reminded of horrible canned peas that just suck. Even if they don't, that's what they remind me of. Just the texture and the can't do it. This fiery overlord is really annoying me. Can we get some DPS on this guy? Thank you. Hey, Ty, what's up? And this hireling's scaring me. He waits just a little too long. Oh yeah, me and carbs are best buddies. I love bread. Oh, I love bread. Pasta, I love pasta. Rice, I love rice. I used to be proud of my college diet, which I could live on under $1 a day. And it was basically all carbs. Oh, Steak and Shake is. Okay, here's the thing about Steak and Shake. If you have 2 or 3 hours to spare, then Steak and Shake is an okay option. Their shakes are decent, their food is okay for diner food, but the service is horrible and slow. And see, I don't like coleslaw either, so. I don't mind a triple burger, and their fries are okay. I don't really like shoestring fries, but they have decent shakes. But yeah. Yeah, I used to have really cheap meals. Yeah, every time I've been to Steak and Shake, especially around here recently, in the past year or two, it was ridiculous. The wait for your food, the wait for Everything was just way too long. What are we doing here? I am. Yeah, laying off carbs sucks. Because carbs are so delicious. Yeah, so I used to have like, a bagel, which I bought in a bag, five for a dollar or whatever. And for lunch, I'd have the cheapest hot dogs imaginable. They were a dollar a pack for the hot dogs and a dollar a pack for the buns. And then I'd have like about a half a box of pasta dripping with butter and pepper. And sometimes, one of my few exceptions, a little bit of Parmesan. And I existed on that mostly every day for 5 years. I mean, we go to like the Chinese buffet and have vegetables and stuff, or go elsewhere and do other things, but that was my major diet. So it's no surprise that I'm now being pre-diabetic, which means right on the edge of being diabetic. Last time I went to the doctor, which is also a couple years ago. Orange chicken is delicious. Orange beef is also delicious. Yeah, I love my Chinese, Thai, Korean, Vietnamese. Dim sum is amazing. Don't like salads at all. Never been a fan of salads. And blue cheese is just disgusting. See, I love broccoli. Broccoli is like the best. I eat broccoli whenever I have the chance, basically. If that's a side option, that's what I'll get wherever I'm eating. What I dislike is when places, particularly expensive frou-frou diner, or not diners, restaurants, that's what I'm trying to think of, they ruin broccoli by having like oil and butter and crap all over. Like, no. No cheese, no nothing. Just broccoli. Steamed broccoli. It's perfectly fine. And I died. Which is not surprising, but. Not Brussels sprouts, but steamed broccoli. And I do not like cauliflower at all. It's got to be broccoli. Cauliflower is. Something is interrupting my attack animation. I don't know what it is. I like green beans a lot too, and some place like Culver's. Oh my God, Culver's ruins their green beans. I don't know what the heck they put in them, but they ruin them. They're horrible. I almost threw up after trying to eat those. I said before, I like snap peas. Edamame is awesome. Yeah, well, it comes with the territory for broccoli. I don't mind. I mean, I go to Culver's for the dessert, obviously. Their custard is good, but the food is okay. I don't mind their fish. I think I've had a burger there too, but Their green beans are horrible. Oh my God. Just bad, bad, bad stuff. Somebody didn't file. There we go. They got the crests. Yeah, I always go for Butterfinger and vanilla when I go to Culver's. That's just what I get. Whether you call them concretes or blizzards or twisters or whatever those are. Oh, one of the local ice cream places during the holidays, which are coming up soon, they've got a great pumpkin spice ice cream, and then they have a, what was the other one? Cinnamon. So I get like two scoops, one of the pumpkin spice, one of the cinnamon, and it just is heavenly. Oh, it's so good. Tyler G, welcome. Hope you're doing well this evening. Thanks for watching. I thought they did, the step bones and hammers and trees did count towards feats. I thought they did, but I could be mistaken. Yeah, I think I only had that combination once last year. We didn't go to that place very often. So we went just when it started and then we missed the rest of it. I definitely want to go back and get some more of that. I'm not much about Greek or Mediterranean in general. I've had some okay shawarma, but the shawarma place here closed down. And yeah. Not sure. There's a couple Mediterranean places we need to try. We had a Peruvian place that burned down. Looks like they're rebuilding it, so hope there's hope on that. I don't like Mexican food except fajitas. That's my one exception to Mexican food. I really enjoy good fajitas. You go to a lot of those Tex-Mex places, and their fajitas consist of a bed of onions and a little bit of steak or chicken or whatever you get. That's crap. The really good Mexican places have really good fajitas. The one here, oh my God. The skillet is piled high with mostly meat. There's some onions and green peppers in there, but it's mostly meat. Chorizo and shrimp and chicken and pork and beef. Oh, it's so good. That is a lot of favorite farming, Tyler G. That's, again, I don't like melted cheese. I don't like tomatoes. So. It counts out a lot of Mexican food. If you notice that, then you're going to the wrong places. No matter what nationality food you eat, if nationals aren't going there, then you're going to the wrong places. So, yeah. But you know, most places I go, I only have one, usually one dish that I get. So if I go to any Mexican place, I just get fajitas. That's my thing. Chinese, if it's a normal American Chinese place, I'll usually get kung pao. Used to be chicken, more often than not. Recently, it's been shrimp. And egg rolls, wonton soup. If it's dim sum, it's completely different depending on what that place has good. Some places have one thing better than another. Love my steamed pork buns. I got a heart of wood in my daily dice roll on Caniff. It's a just plain old hard wood, I think. I was less than impressed. It's not what I needed. I also think tokens would be easier to get, depending on what you're doing. Yeah, steamed pork buns rock. So if anybody is in or around or has plans to visit at any time the Milwaukee area in Wisconsin, go to Brookfield, which is what, northwest of Milwaukee, and go to Ming's Takeout. Order yourself some egg rolls and some wonton soup, and it will blow your mind. It is so delicious and good and amazing and oh. And yes, the daily dice roll. If you're free to play, you get one silver roll a day, which is basically just 1d100. And it's kind of like a casino game, so it's very loaded, but yeah. And then if you're a VIP, you get a gold roll, which has the same stuff but much better prizes in theory. So like on a daily roll, if you get like a tome roll, you might get a +4 tome. If you're VIP and you get a gold roll and you get that same roll, you get maybe a +5 or +6 tome. So it's just a neat thing to keep you logging in every day, basically. Get some free stuff by logging in and hitting a roll. Oh, you also get some XP usually, which is nice. They can be handy. Yeah. Occasionally you'll roll 100. Actually, 1 in 100 times you'll roll 100. So that's let's see, that's what, once in 2 years on a gold roll, and 3 times a year on a silver roll. I'm primarily running on Thelanus. I'm on Thelanus right now. I do have the same character. Seamorgue Zergs is on every server. So I do have at least one character on every server. My backup server is probably Caniff at this point. And, yeah. Well, City, get yourself out to Ming's and get yourself some really, 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 really super awesome Chinese food. Because it's amazing. No, Gemini had a dental appointment and did not stream. I was playing on Kyber last night. Played Caniff on Friday. But more, normally I play on Thelanus. I may log in on my characters on, or a character on every server to get my daily rolls, but or at least my weekly rolls. That's too bad, City. They really are amazing. You get the same stuff on every server, it's just different people. The servers are all the same otherwise. Wayfinder, although, is very sparsely populated. So Be aware of that. Other than that, it doesn't really matter which one you pick. Just normally, I recommend when you go to each server, create a character, and then just kind of see when you're normally going to be playing. Look at the group panel here, the LFMs, and just get a feeling for when people, which server has more people playing when you're playing, or if you get in a guild on a server, make sure they're going to be around when you're around. My guild on Thelanus is all European based, and I'm in the US, so I sometimes don't see a lot of them on when I play. So, Skunk, I asked you twice yesterday in Gemini's chat if you were playing last night, and you did not respond either time. So don't even. Besides the fact, I have no idea what your character names are. Evidently, you didn't favorite my character on your server. You know my character name, so that's on you, dude. And yes, City, that's the other thing. Go ahead and run some quests, get yourself some levels, play all the low-level quests, get 100 favor, and get some extra free turbine points to buy stuff with. Just check them out and see. You're going to be happiest if you can find LFMs when you the time you play. And if you can find a guild that's also playing the time you play, that's what you're going to be happiest, I think, when you play. I don't know. I might play for another hour or two. I may not. I mean, feel free to go. You can always watch the VOD. And I cannot move. There we go. Must have been. I tried to ask you what was going on, dude. I would have pinged you in game, but I didn't know having your character names, so. Oh, I should probably stone skin myself, just get that little extra damage. All right, Skylar, thanks for stopping by. Hope you have a good night. That would be that website. And Simorgh exists on all the servers, so no matter what server you play on, you can friend Simorgh and be alerted when I log on and all that fun stuff. I just heard a cat doing something he shouldn't be doing. Ain't that right, cat? That's cool. Yep. And I have my app, my website working for tracking people's characters on and stuff. I just need to make it so that I don't have to manually enter through the database all the data. Need to figure out how to do that part. I'm gonna use for authentication and get an interface in to edit stuff. But it displays all my characters just fine. I'm actually gonna switch to that instead of what I have there at some point. Oh. Trying to save my action boosts for the Hazro and stuff. That's cool. The two characters that I know I have, well, pretty much on every server, I have a PDK that's level 15, and then I have a Morning Lock that's level 15. Caneth, my Morning Lock, is level 22, I think. And my Kyber one might actually be level 16. I'm not sure. Our party leader seems to be idling quite a lot. Yeah, if you've. You know, somebody did some rearranging on the ship, I noticed last night when I logged on to Caneth. I was annoyed. They moved the Spirit Binder and the Orient Express down near the green steel crafting. Or was it Caneth crafting? I forget. Which you can now craft from your bags, so why do you need the bank next to the freaking crafting? You can use your bags. Speaking of which, I should plug that link, my airship layout link again. Maybe if I die here, or if I get a chance between waves. Let's see, this one. So I moved it back. We'll see how long that war lasts. Like, all the interactives are on the first floor. Keep them all on the first floor. It makes sense that way. I don't know why you would move that stuff to a different floor. You got your repair person, you've got most of your vendors, you've got your mail, auction house, bank, you got your teleporter, all on the first floor. It makes a whole lot of sense. You're only going down to the crafting area if you want to craft something. So yeah, that image on the right there of the page, I added to the DDO wiki as well, because for some reason nobody had taken or uploaded a screen cap of the floor plan, which I thought was weird. That's not an issue, that's working as designed. Working as intended, sorry. They were never supposed to work that way. Cargo hold buffs are supposed to go away at some point. In fact, they were supposed to go away within a couple releases, and they haven't yet. Our guild, frankly, didn't even worry about it most of the time. Started playing lower level characters again. We went and started redoing just the elemental resists, but other than that, we don't really worry about that stuff. Yeah, that's how I felt every time I got on that ship. I always had to run around looking for stuff, and I got tired of it. It's like, let's make this some logical thing. Whoa, hello, that hit really hard. That hit really, really hard. There we go. Get within range of a hireling. That's a good idea. Oh, I got stunned. That's what I'm saying. That's the only thing we worry about in the cargo hold, and it's quick enough just to go down there and do that, and then go back up and do the rest of your stuff. Besides, higher level, it doesn't even matter. You don't even need those. So, you get elemental resists from your newer amenities. They're just not as good at lower levels as the ones you get from the cargo hold. Man, he is just tearing me apart. Nobody have anything to knock him down a bit? Pause him or stuff? Because he's a big bag of hit points. Oh, I got knocked down. This could be bad. Oh, wow. That was close. That was closer than I prefer. Hello, cocoon, thank you. See, I don't craft, so I always just go down to the first floor, repair, immediately go over to the Three Finger Thad's, sell stuff, and then if I need to go in the bank or auction house or check my mail, I do that, and then over to the teleporter, and I'm out. Takes me so little time if the air shut is properly set up to get through that stuff. And then, yeah, you hit the bar as soon as you get to the ship. I mean, that's a given. The buff bar, I mean. And then, I'm ready for the next quest in like a minute. It's part of Zerging that I want to talk about on the Zerg show is getting through your stuff and being ready to go to the next quest immediately. And not spending forever looking through your cache or whatever. That's why I said all the interactables, one floor. So that you go to the first floor, you immediately walk into the repair guy, you go left again, there's your guy to sell. Turn around, and then there's your bank and auction house and mail, and then flip to the other side real quick, and then there's your teleporter to go back out to wherever you're going to the quest. It's efficient, it's quick. You don't have to go from floor to floor to floor. In fact, the only reason you go to another floor is A, go to the cargo hold if you want those buffs, and B, if you want to craft, go to the third floor to do the crafting stuff. Other than that, you don't even need to go to the second floor ever, or the fourth floor ever. All those buffs are from the bar on top, which you hit on your way down. So that is why I advocate that layout, or a layout similar to the one I posted there. Extra 51K, not bad. Anything good there? Nope. Anything good there? Nope. All right. As I said, I left that party. I need to go to the Fate Spinner real quick and level my epic level. Equip my better axe. And then I'm going to switch characters because I'm kind of done with this for the moment. I'll play something else. Agree, Skunk. Oh, this is a stat level. Okay. Why can I not move that out of my way? I have to rethink my placement of this. All right. Get my extra plus one strength there. What are we feeling for epic feats today? I believe I feel like epic toughness. There we go, we're above 800 now. That's nice. Where's my other axe? Spend your TP on bags, kids. They make things much easier. Problem with having so many inventory slots is finding the inventory thing you want. Okay, so I think what I want to do is move that there, and then move that there and equip that one. There we go. That is this memorial ribbon, Tyler. It was sold briefly as a memorial to the Boston bombing, since Turbine is headquartered in Boston. I picked it up in the auction house for like 2 million plat, because I was not playing during that particular time, so I did not see it up for sale. But it's a neat little extra that I like to have. Not a lot of people have them, so it's kind of nice to be able to point out my character quickly and easily by wearing it. Unfortunately, only one character has it, so I can't, when I switch characters, I don't lose it. I lose it, so I can't use it again on a different character. But it's okay. See, this is what I'm talking about. I just got to the airship. I hit my buff bar on the way in. I'm on the first floor. As soon as I can move, I go straight to the repair guy, which is right here in front of my face. Hit repair. Turn left. Turn left. Here's Thad's, where I can sell everything I don't need. Sell my gems, sell that, done. If I needed to check my mail, auction house, or bank, it's right here, which I was going to bank these dragon shards, that crossbow, those bolts, and then go over this side. And there's my teleport. I can go wherever I need to go. Oh, I blew 6 million plat, I think. If you're doing the epic grind, you make so much platinum that it's ridiculous. Like this life, I've made like 500K, I think. I don't remember if I actually got stuff out of the bank or not. But I've got 500K right now on this one character. But I played a lot of Epic, and Epic gives you quite a lot of cash. So I'm sitting at 5 mil in my shared account bank. I've got 5 mil plat there. I've got 500K on this character, and who knows what I have on my other characters. Now, it's not on a per quest basis. It's as you play. I mean, look, here, let's put it this way. If I can get this to move where I need it to move so I can actually see it. There we go. Okay. I've maxed out all the destinies, right? So that's what, 24 million XP there alone. Plus the fact that this is my 12th epic life. So I have 11 past lives. So multiply that 6 by 11. That's another 66 million. So that's what, 80 some, 90 million. So in the course of getting 90 million XP, I've gotten maybe 12 million plat. If you look at it from that perspective, then it's easier to understand why I have so much plat. See, I've never heroic true reincarnate. This character has stayed in epics the entire time. So I went, maxed out all my destinies, and sometimes I epic reincarnated, sometimes I didn't. Sometimes I just stayed at cap, just kept farming the XP for the destinies and getting heart seeds to get the TRs, or epic reincarnate wood, heart of woods and stuff. You know what I mean? So when you look at it from that perspective, it's not a big deal. If you continually go back and TR, or you haven't progressed very far in epics, then yeah, you're not going to have much money. The other thing is, I don't spend a lot on consumables. I know a lot of people spend a lot of money on consumables. I don't. It's just not how I play. Yeah, I don't know how much I have on Canth currently, but part of that was I sold the Flawless Siberius Dragon Shard, I think it was. Whatever the other option that's not a portable hole is from the Agents of Arcanism favor. I read in the forums that you don't take the portable hole, you take the Flawless Dragon Shard, put the Flawless Dragon Shard up in the auction house, and you'll sell it for, say, two or three times what a portable hole costs, and then you buy your portable hole out of that money. Anyway, that's why I advocate, this is why I'm advocating this layout, and that's how you get platinum. And just to complete the tour of the airship, as that page lays out, here's all your hirelings. You can grab one right before you go to the teleporter. Your ammo vendor's there. Your training dummies are there. Over here, you've got your divine trapsmith, arcane vendors, your arcane vendor, you've got your spirit binder, then on this other side, you have your guild vault and your repair guy again. So this floor is really most of the interactive stuff that you're going to want over and over again as you run through stuff. Now, if you go look at, if you go down to the cargo hold, here's our cargo hold. It's empty except for those five elemental buffs. And here's the fun graphics glitch of the slightly offset wallpaper texture thing. Yeah. Oh, and also turn the cannon on. So that's why I'm advocating the layout as I am. Because the way our guild is, we don't really keep up on the cargo hold buffs anymore. We've pretty much switched, except for when you're low level and those buffs are handy, then we have those for that instance. Otherwise, you pretty much don't have to leave the first deck. The second deck, just to show you while I'm here, and we're doing this airship tour. Yeah, bathhouse never gets used. Paradoxical Puzzle Box, the Distillery, the Grog Cellar, whichever. This is all stuff that gives you the passive buffs from the buff bar on top. Chronoscope for your run speed, experience boost, of course. Grand Reliquary. Got your Hag Apothecary, your Ninja Assassin. Your Bash Breakables Cargo Bay. Wii Breakables. And your Floating Rock Garden. Again, except for the Cargo Bay, which really is useless, then there's no reason to go there. The second floor ever, really. There's no real interactives. And then, but you only go to the third floor. This is your Greensteel Crafting Hall. We've got your Arc Wizard. Which one was this one? Black Abbot Shadow. Here's your Caineth Crafting Hall. And over here, you've got your Autos Irresistible Dance Hall, your Concert Hall on the other side. You have your game hunter, and here is your danger room. Oh my God, dog, did you die?
Oh. Oh. Whew.
Okay, now I'll go in the danger room. See, it's not so bad. Anyway, like I said, except for these two crafting halls, there's nothing really to come down here for. So. Yeah, I bought a couple of rubies with plat. I bought a couple tomes with plat. I bought my ribbon with plat. Yeah. I don't know. It's laid out this way. We have a guy in our guild that does optimizations, and this was how he determined the most optimal thing was, and I tend to agree with him on, at least for our guild level and our the way we play, that I think it's worth spreading the love, which is why I made that page that shows the layout. And we aren't to 150 yet, so there's some other things we can upgrade and get to make it even better. But for the most part, I think it works pretty well. This is when I usually do a self promo, so let's do that. And going to take a short break. It's been 2.5 hours, and I have not taken a break yet, so I'm going to get up and stretch. Smells like the dog needs to go out, or he's dying, one of the two. Wow. And, so, yeah, I'll be back in a couple minutes. Let's say 5-ish. I'll come back on, I don't know, my sorcerer, I guess. But yeah. Say 10-minute break. I will talk to you soon. Yeah, that's Wild Titan. And I am back. Two rainbow walls. I've never had that part take that long, even with only two people, I think. Yeah, city in Shroud. What is that, part three? The part with the puzzles and running the water. If you take too long, a rainbow wall of death will come and start circling. And it's an insta kill if you get hit by it, or sometimes anywhere close to it. Even if it doesn't look like you get hit, you get hit. It's kind of annoying that way. But yeah, I've never seen two. Seen one plenty of times, but never seen two. Let's see if we can get into this LFM. Yeah, you need some decent DPS too. Oh, what the heck? Our guild chat group failed part one until we got the a handle on the whole portal keeper thing, which I had never seen because, you know, usually you're doing it with 28s, so it's not a big deal. DPS doesn't matter in that part. You're talking about part one. All you need to know about part one is the portal keeper shows up, kill it immediately. Let's see how much XP I missed out on. A bit. Yeah, you need to. Part one is a bunch of needing to move quickly and beat those portals down as fast as you can. Really, we're gonna do this? All right. All right, what are my heals on this character? Ah, that's right. My heals are that. Lita Ford. Wow. I went with the mint and cream Oreos for my snack. If there was some more communication of where we needed to go, I would help, but, no, Titan. Yeah, mint and cream Oreos are my favorite Oreos at the moment. The key lime pie ones were amazing, but they were limited. So unfortunately, you can't get them anymore. Those were the best. The brownie batter ones are kind of weird, but for some reason, they're addictive. They're not really good, though. I don't know why. Hard to stop eating them. Yeah, I'm really not much one for sweets that much, but the SO is, so they tend to be around. If it's not around, I don't really worry about it. I don't crave it, but if it's around, then I eat it. So now I've got these wasabi and soy sauce brown rice Triscuit thin crisps. So this group is not going well. Couple people are AFK now. I don't know which tower has been done, or I'd go at least help do it. At this point, I'd almost say just go grab the factory, everybody come back in, get assigned towers, and do it right. That is an excellent idea. Thanks for stopping by, City. Hope you have a good evening. See you next time. Sounds like somebody's doing traps at least. That's cool. And this will get me a rank in Legendary Dreadnought because I'm a sorcerer and I need Legendary Dreadnought. Ugh. In reality, I do need it. It's like get over here and get Cocoon. Just, there's not really much in here for me. Taking whatever just to get up. I'm taking mostly Constitution, I think, the whole way up. I'm gonna go ahead and max it just to have it max, but I just think that's worth it. It's worth going ahead and maxing. Oh, there's an EE Whiz King up. Interesting. Not on this character. Don't think so. Oh, that reminds me. Oh, all right. The Epic Inferno Bracers because of the combustion. That's right. And I've got the Epic Cloak of Flames for the Fire Lore. The rock epic rock boots for the acid lore and corrosion. Green steel gloves for the spell points. Hit points on a ring. Epic Eye of the Beholder for the death block. Absorb spells. Wizardry. Don't have armor. Wow, I need to re-gear. I got the epic Minos. Got so many sources of spell points, but they don't stack. That's amazing. Constitution and more hit points. So yeah, I need to re-gear at some point here. Preferably with more. Oh, why is are there heart seeds that aren't in my bag? Mean, this character is doing okay, but definitely need to re-gear. I really need that? Probably not. Wow. Yeah, I need to figure that out. Impulse, acid lure, corrosion, acid lure. But I've got the quarterstaff with potency and spell lore and corrosion and combustion. So those quarterstaves are really nice if you can get the right combination for you. 316 acid, 397 fire. With 31 and 35 critical chances. But I like how my critical multiplier is zero. What? Pretty sure I should have something other than zeros for my critical multiplier. Hey, look, I critted for zero. Because if you multiply it by zero, then it's zero. I'm definitely doing damage when I crit. That would appear to be a bug of some sort. Oh, they're finally at Hammy. At this point, everybody's away. There we go. So let's see if we can do this again, or people are going to leave, or what's going to happen. I don't mind doing that again. Hopefully, with assignments this time, so we can burn through it. I don't remember how to grab the window, or I would grab the window. Click the dungeon entrance and hold it until I recall. That's right, that's how you do it. It's literally just grabbing, putting the window up, making sure you have it. That's right, okay. Some guy's hopelessly confused. Yay, SLAs for the win. See what works against these guys. Disintegrate. Yep, disintegrate seems to work. Hit for over 2,000. I say that worked. Let's let him get the aggro. Trapper go first. It's generally solid device. I'm not sure I have fully figured out the spell point management, but you know. They're not activating. All right. We'll take that then. We lost the lottery. It's Ryum. Just grab the factory because diamond to listen plus 11 on. Oh, I didn't even see that. Yay! Oh, yeah, Skunk. I finally got that Topaz of Death block on Caneth. There was finally one up for a reasonable price. Well, I say reasonable, it was like 150k, but that's relatively reasonable compared to the 800k or whatever the other one was. And there's still one. Oh, the other one disappeared, though. That's good. Just just one ghost LFM now. Got so many spell points. If I just had Cocoon, I would keep myself alive much better. That's my plan, is to get over there and get Cocoon. I just have to wonder what everybody else is doing, though. I mean, yeah, there were three of us, but seriously, what's taking so much time? Could have thrown a couple more disintegrates. Oh, hey, look. I have. Getting low on level 7. What's level 7? Nothing that I use much. That doesn't use. Yes, it does use. Oh, did I? Yeah. Heat death. I think I had to delete less far. Oh, there it is. I need to instant. D3 plus 30, 20 D3 plus 60. So yeah, delay plus fireball is definitely better. It also costs a whole lot more points. That's what I want to see. Keep getting these ranks in Legendary Dreadnought. Get through these so I can move on to something more interesting or more useful anyway. I hate to end on such a boring note, but I think I'm going to. Might add over to Caneth or Kyber or something and play offline or off stream. Do some inventory management or guild airship rearrangement or something. Unless there's a good group open. No. No good LFMs up. I guess I could watch something. Don't know. I have no idea what you're talking about, Titan. I've never seen Airbender stuff. A 30-pound cheeseburger. That's a heavy cheeseburger. Or expensive, or both. Somebody walking in the treasure chamber. Oh, yep, gotta wait for the actual guy. There we go. Seriously, somebody walk into the treasure chamber. Five, four, three, two, one. Okay, fine. Don't care. Love how that pops right under where I need to be. Ah, wrong window. Don't care about the loot. That's the second holy burst thing I've had tonight. In the way of crossbows. I think that was a repeater, though. Oh, and if you're in LA, then it's early, so it makes sense for you to be eating dinner at this time. I don't know why I didn't just teleport back to the thing. All right, I think that's going to do it for me tonight. Thank you everyone for watching. I do appreciate it. I'm here most Tuesdays on this channel. I'm also on my own channel at various times. Lately I've been Fridays. I will not be on this Friday. But we appreciate you watching DDO Stream, the official DDO streaming gaming live TV like channel. There's several of us who stream on here. Check the schedule. Either below the video if you're on a PC, it'll replace the video when I go offline. Or if you're on mobile, you can tap the video, hit the I button, and it'll get you to the schedule. That's it for me, and yeah. See y'all next week, if not before. Happy hunting. Good night.